So 30 minutes for 4 years.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
I'd like to thank the organizer for the invitation to give a presentation in this symposium. My presentation is about the characteristic of dengue virus in Indonesia. Before I'm starting, I'd like to start with this contributors and acknowledgement, because this, they are people that are important in this study. So basically, we are collaborating with Indonesian institutions, universities, and so on. This is the Eijkman Institute team, and then we also collaborate with Erlangga University, Dr. Aryati, Dr. Puspa, from Hasanuddin University, Diponegoro University, and so on. My talk will be consisted of two parts. The first one is the genetic characterization of dengue virus in Indonesia, and it will be about our dengue surveillance, its dengue data in Indonesia, and then the distribution of the serotype, and then genetic data from the genome sequence, as well as the evolutionary rates. And then the second part will be the phenotypic characterization of the viruses in Indonesia. It's some of them will be like the viral loads, and then replication kinetics, the characteristic of the plaques, and so on. So I think it's quite common already. This I think I will skip this, but I'd like to emphasize of these factors that contributes to dengue disease. So we know already about the host factors, immune status, race, and so on. But then I will talk about, mostly my talk will be about the virus factors. So we know that there are many genotypes within serotypes, and then the epigenetic structure, mutant selection, neutralization, escape, and so on. So my talk will be talking about the virus and not talking lots about the host factors. So this slide describes the presence of genotypes within serotypes. So we know that dengue, there are four serotypes of dengue, but within the serotype, there are many genotypes here based on the E-protein homology. And here you can see that lots of genotypes within dengue 1, there are 5 at the moment, and then dengue 3, dengue 2, and so on. Then I will emphasize of these genotypes, because my talk lots will be talking a lot about the genotypes. So please be in mind that within the serotypes there are genotypes. So the dengue genotype, maybe Jeremy has also mentioned brief about the dengue genotypes. There are two aspects of the genotypes of the dengue virus that can be attributed to the genotype. The first one is the geographical distribution, and the second one is the fitness and the virulence. The geographical distribution of dengue genotypes is quite specific, at least at the moment. Maybe in the future there will be no genotype geographical distribution anymore, because people already move and no barriers and in within continent and so on. But then also the other aspect of the dengue genotype is the fitness and virulence. Some genotypes known to be to have a better fitness compared to other genotypes, and with the fitness of the a particular genotype, then it can replace genotype which got a lower fitness, and this is happen. I will talk about this as well in our result. And then we know that some genotype got different virulence, like the American genotype is low virulence compared to the Southeast Asian dengue genotype. But then, as I said, the distribution of the genotype and the viral fitness are dynamics, and it can be not really, it has to be depend on the many factors of the transport and so on. The distribution will be quite dynamics. So to study the genotype and serotype distribution of the dengue in Indonesia, we perform like a kind of surveillance and data collections in 11 cities in 6 major islands. These cross-sectional is only like a cross-sectional collection of data for samples, few months, 6 months until 1 year, and it's an active surveillance, active sample collection, and all samples were confirmed for dengue. And so this on this presentation, all samples are confirmed, so either by the NS1 or AGM ELISA or the genome detection, and also virus isolation. So these are the samples that currently we are collecting, and we got already 11 cities here. This is the total number of samples, and then the samples that have been serotyped, and then the genotype of the sample is determined as well. These are the collaborative effort of our collaborators. I would say it can mention lots of collaborators here, Dr. Ariati, Isra Wahid, and so on. And some of the cities got quite complete data, so that I can present here the temporal and age distributions, like in Makassar and Surabaya and Semarang. It's quite a lot of number of samples here. So basically, the message here is that in each city, the distribution of dengue cases, temporal distribution is quite different. For example, this is here in Makassar, which is going down here. But it seems that within this month of after the rainy season, the trend is quite high in these cities, at least in these cities. It could be different in other cities as well, of course. About the age distribution, it's quite diverse as well, but the thing is most of the sample basically in children, but the cases in Makassar is quite high in young adolescents and young people. And this is the genotype distribution, serotype distribution of the dengue in Indonesia from 8 cities. You can see here that in each city, the distribution is quite diverse. The serotype distribution is quite diverse as well. And in each year, so this is it's a past and a current distribution. Like this one is 2002 and then 96, but we got some new data in 2012 in Surabaya here, and then 2010 Makassar. So here, yeah, basically by the time the distribution of serotype, dengue serotype, moving up, and it's quite different from example, this one here, the Surabaya in 2012, it's different from previous data. So after getting the serotypes data on dengue in Indonesia, then we perform a genomic analysis to get the genotypes of the viruses in Indonesia. So this is the method that we are using at the moment. And we did the phylogenetic analysis to group the dengue viruses in Indonesia into several genotypes here. So this is a dengue one. So basically, there are three genotypes here in Indonesia at the moment for dengue one. So this is I will talk about this later as well. But yeah, it's quite complicated data, but I'll just skip this. This is for dengue two. Cosmopolitan genotype in Indonesia. The red samples are from Indonesia. And this is dengue 3, a single genotype here in Indonesia. They all are dengue 1, genotype 1. And dengue 4, they all are genotype 2. So with this data, then we can map the distribution of the genotypes in Indonesia. If we look at the previous publication here for the dengue one, within the last few decades, the genotype of dengue one in Indonesia mostly are genotype 4. But then with the time, genotype 1 is appearing here in Makassar as well. It's found in Makassar, but still genotype 4 is still there as well in Surabaya, in Bali and in Surabaya. But then we also found this new genotype that never been mentioned in Indonesia. I'll talk about this as later. Dengue 2, those all genotypes are the same. They are the cosmopolitan genotypes. Dengue 3, there are single genotype here, genotype 1 for Indonesia. And dengue 4, there are also single genotype, there are genotype 2s in all the whole Indonesia. So, as I mentioned before, we found a new genotype, the dengue 2 genotype 1, which is quite strange because this samples, the isolated in Semarang, actually not Semarang, it's Ungaran, was very, very closely related with the strain that is used for generating vaccine. So this is very closely related, and the interesting thing is that this genotype is never reported in the last 4 decades. So if you look at the gene bank data and then screen for search for the dengue 2 genotypes, you will only find around 3 to 5, and all belongs to this PDK strain, and also what this professor has said, isolated back in 1964. This genotype is, you as you see here, it's very, very slowly evolve. So it's got a very slow evolutionary rate, so compared to other viruses in other genotypes. So as I mentioned before, this one is closely related to this strain, and then never reported in the last 4 decades. And other interesting thing is that this genotype is found in a high altitude area in village in the Mount of Ungaran, and yes, it's got a very slow evolutionary rate. So what is the explanation? We don't know yet, but it could be that this one is this genotype could be that it is a dormant or circulating in low number. We don't know yet, and it's quite interesting too to know whether this genotype is escaped from cross neutralization, so that they can behave like this. But then we try to confirm whether this genotype 2 cross neutralized by other genotype. So we perform a PRNT test on the genotype. So we use the genotype 1, 2, and 4 viruses as the challenge virus, and then we use the dengue 1 immune healthy human sera as the neutralizing antibodies. We got some collection of this, and then looking at the data here, this is only representative data. There are lots of plugs as well here, but the thing is actually using this 3 viruses, the antibody from the healthy human can still neutralize all of the viruses. So it's good news actually for the vaccine development as well, because even different genotypes, the peculiar genotypes here can still be neutralized by human antibodies here. So there are three samples here, three human healthy human, and they all got a similar dilution titer of sera to neutralize the viruses. And then we also have some data on the severity of the patients, but we would like to know whether there is a relationship between serotype with the severity of the disease. So these are the graph that we got from the data analysis, and this is the number of the samples. It appeared that there are some differences in each serotypes to get the different clinical manifestation, the dengue fever and then THF, but still the data is not statistically significant for this. And given that Indonesia got the 3 genotypes, we would like also to know whether there is a relationship between genotype with the severity of the disease. So we compare the genotype 1 of the dengue 1 with the genotype 4. It appears that this is the percentage. The genotype 4 is quite high in generating a THF, but then it's not statistically significant. And what about the infection status? The infection status in Indonesia, if you look at this data, Dengue 1, most of them are secondary infection. They are basically quite a lot of second infection here. And compared, if we compare the primary and secondary infection of the infection status with the severity of the disease, we found that this is quite it is confirming previous data that in secondary infection it's tend to get the more severe disease. So in summary, for this genetic data, we have got data on the serotypes distribution, and we also got the data on the genotype distribution here. There are three genotypes of Dengue 1, single genotype for Dengue 2, 3, and 4. These are the cities where they are circulating at the moment. But I'm sure it's not only this city, in the whole Indonesia, there will be quite similar distribution of genotypes. Because we don't have the samples, then we don't know exactly what the genotypes in Indonesia. There's still a lot of things to do to know the genetic characteristic of dengue in Indonesia. So this information contributes to the data of the genotype distribution in the world, actually. So, but like this one here, we know that Dengue 1 is not only genotype 2 and 3, but also genotype 1 and 4 and for in Indonesia. This data here is genetic analysis of the sequence genome of the dengue viruses here. So I just bring this is because of the dengue one got the two genotypes, genotype 1 and 4, and if we align the sequence of the E protein, then it is quite clear that the genotype 1 is quite uniform, and it suggests that it's maybe recently introduced, hasn't got lots of mutation in the genome compared to the genotype 4, which is quite diverse. These are all of the polymorphism in the E protein of the genotype 4. So also for the NS1 gene polymorphism, we got quite a lot of polymorphism in all of the Indonesian data viruses here, but most of the polymorphism are constrained, so it's not getting, I mean, like conserved polymorphism, not causing the virus to behave to evolve strangely, something like that. Oh yeah, given the presence of lots of polymorphism here, so we would like to correlate with the NS1 data, because recently we performed NS1 evaluation of the ELISA evaluation, the PanBio. If I saw Dr. Herman here just published the BioRed Platelia NS1 sensitivity, we perform a PanBio ELISA sensitivity, and here actually PanBio is still a little bit better than BioRed here. We got 56%. It's quite low, still very low here. But BioRed, I think it's around 40-something percent sensitivity. So we correlate this data with the polymorphism in the NS1 of the dengue viruses in Indonesia. So with this very low sensitivity, so it's half of the, almost half actually, the NS1, PanBio NS1 detection may be giving wrong results. So if we look at the epitopes of the NS1, there are a published epitope of the NS1 here, four epitopes here, and we align the epitopes, non-epitope, with our data here. Basically, there are polymorphism observed in the epitopes, but the presence of the polymorphism is also a presence is both in both NS1 positive and NS1 negative isolates. So this polymorphism in the epitopes is unlikely to affect the NS1 ELISA sensitivity. And based on the phylogenetic tree, then we can refer for the evolutionary rates of the dengue viruses in Indonesia. If you look at here, this is the evolutionary rates. The evolutionary rate is an estimation of the nucleotide substitution among viruses, so it's useful in understanding the history, epidemiological history of the viruses. Here, in general, there are quite similar common similarity with the common evolutionary rates for dengue 4, except for the dengue genotype 2 that I mentioned before here, which is very slowly mutated here. So, and the dengue 4 is recently we got the sequence for the dengue 4. It's quite interesting because the rates of the evolution in this dengue 4 is quite faster than the common rates of dengue 4 in the world. So we got already the genetic data, and then we move to the phenotypic data. So we have performed some biological characterization of the dengue viruses. So we have done some replication in vivo, and then DENVI replication in vitro, and plug size morphology, and so on. I'll talk about this. So the first data that we observe for the viral load, it's actually confirming the previous finding that in THF, in the dengue fever, in a severe dengue, the viral load in the patient are higher than the one in the TF. And what about the serotypes? Within serotypes, the viral loads for each serotype is quite similar as well. It's not that different here, and it's not statistically significant. But some serotype, some strain actually got the very high viremia. This is outliers here, lots of outliers there. So it's some strain got it's not quite, it's not very homogeneous, but some strain got a very high viremia load. And then we also perform genetic replication kinetic study of the viruses from Indonesia. We perform using the plug assay to compare the isolates from different serotypes, so to look at whether each strain got their own characteristic. So this is this the virus is grown in Marfero cells and then plucked on BHK21, and these are the data here. The blue color are the dengue 1, three strains of dengue 1, three different strains. The dengue 2, three different strains as well, the red colors, and dengue 3 and dengue 4. So basically, if you look at here, they are quite similar between strain, among strain, the replication kinetics are quite similar here. And it is concluded that the replication rate of dengue in Indonesia is like this. Dengue 2 is the faster growing viruses, and then followed by dengue 4 and the dengue 1 and dengue 3. These are the mean of this data. What about the genotype growth kinetic? So we know that we have two genotypes of dengue 1, three genotypes of dengue 1. So we also compare the rates of replication in Vero cells as well. And looking at this, you know that this blue color are the genotype 1, and the red color are the genotype 4, and the single genotype here is the genotype 2. Looking at this, it is clear that the genotype 1 is replicated faster than genotype 2 and genotype 4. So we also look at the plaque morphology, because the plaque size is basically correlate with the virulence in a neurovirulence study in suckling mice model. So we perform plaque assay in PHK cell lines here to look at the plaque morphology and plaque size. So these are the sum of representative of the plaque morphology of dengue viruses from Indonesia. We got a lot of data, but this is only to give you a picture how what is the plaque look like. So this is dengue 1. It's quite diverse here, the big plaques, medium plaques, and then small plaques. Dengue 3, dengue 2 is tend to have a very, very big plaques here. Dengue 3, there are quite diverse as well. But the dengue 4, the 10 is always a quite small plaque, and it's not clear here, the plaque is not that set through some cells there. So this is the characteristic of plaques in of the dengue viruses in Indonesia. It's, they're quite diverse morphology. And what about the plaque size? So we measure the plaque size on dengue viruses on 6 days incubation in pH kit 21 cells. So these are the plaques of 28 samples, 28 different strain of dengue viruses. We got genotype 1, genotype 4 of dengue 1. The blue color are dengue 1, genotype. So this is dengue 2, dengue 3, and dengue 4. Looking at this, it's quite diverse as well. And when we got the mean of the data, then this is the plaque diameter size, which is consistently the dengue 2 got a quite high large size compared to others. And then we know that in the dengue pathogenesis, cytokine storm is also contributes to the pathogenesis of the disease. So we look, we would like to know whether serotypes and can related to the disease severity by looking at the cytokine and chemokines that is upregulated in dengue infection. So we perform cytokine expression profiling. And the first was in that there are many publications on the cytokine profiling of dengue patient. Lots of cytokines has been identified. We also perform in vitro infection using the model here and found that some cytokines are upregulated within upon dengue infection. But what about in human primary cell line cells? So we would like to know whether each serotypes, each genotypes, or each strain of dengue viruses got the different induction capacity of the cytokine levels. So we perform this experiment, cytokine profiling in macrophages and PBMC. So basically we collected macrophages and then we differentiate them and then we infect with the strains of viruses here, and then we measure the cytokine using the Luminex platform. Basically a simultaneous measurement of this is not six, it's eight cytokines which are known to be involved in dengue pathogenesis simultaneously. So this is our preliminary data. So out of eight cytokines, only three actually got very quite high induction. The other five are quite similar for each other, and some of them were not induced compared to the control. And here the IP10 in macrophages, the dengue one here seems that it's differently induced the IP10 expression in macrophages compared to other serotypes here. Red are the dengue 2 and then dengue 3, dengue 4, and dengue 1. As well as the IL10 here, the dengue 1 is quite high inducing IL-10 and interferon alpha 2. Those two are the anti-inflammatory. This is a antiviral cytokines and this is an anti-inflammatory cytokines. And what about in PBMC? The behavior is quite different because in PBMC there are the IL-10 is not induced, but the IP-10 still induced. The data is quite confusing here, but it looks like again the dengue one induced in the IP10 better than other cell types. I think that's my presentation, and we already seen the distribution of the dengue serotype in Indonesia is quite dynamics, and then also we also observe the diversity of the genetics of dengue virus in Indonesia. The genotype in dengue virus in Indonesia has been determined. The presence of genotype replacement, which is dengue 1 genotype 1 is slowly replacing the genotype 4 of the dengue 1. And also we found the genotype 2, which is quite a new genotype, never been reported before. We determine the evolutionary rates of the viruses, the viral loads, and the replication kinetic and the plaque morphology. as well as the induction of cytokines on dengue infection. Thank you.
Okay, thank you Pak Tejo Sasmono for very interesting presentation, very complicated.